Well, Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai in Masechet Sukkah daf Mem Hei says, "Yecholani liftor et ha'olam min hadin. I have the power to take away judgment from the world." Or expressions like "Ana simana be'alma," I am a sign for the world. Or even furthermore, when he said that "Ra'iti ibn Aliyah ve'em me'atim," says, "I see that those who are called Bnei Aliyah," as we know when
Mi ala le'echal Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai. Ramah mi she'eno me'apech mtiku le mriru le mtiku Rabbi Tarfon, Rabbi Mizaya.
When the Tana came up to the Echal of Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai, he said, "The one that doesn't know how to transform darkness into light, lo yehon adacha, he shouldn't come through this door." That is Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai. When finally Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai says that if there are Bnei Aliyah, these people which can transform the darkness into light, the bitterness into sweetness, if there's only two in the world, it's my son and me. If there's only one, it's me. We continue with such expressions in the Zohar Kadosh. It says, "Shalosh pe'amim b'shana yirae kol zechurecha et p'nei ha'adon Hashem." 3 times a year you will come to see the face of your master, the master, Hashem. So really there's a question, why does it say your master, Hashem? Hashem is your master. What do you need to add to that? He says, "Man pnei ha'adon, da pnei Rashbi." Who is the face of your master? Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai. So obviously, these are all questions. How wondrous it is that a person to such a high level, that when it says, "Na'aseh Adam ne'emar ba'avurecha," when God said, "Let us create man," he had intention, Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai. And this, the tsa'ar of the Me'ara, that Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai was in the Me'ara for 12 years, in the earth, buried in the earth. God recreated man. So to understand how it's possible to have these two opposites, a level of Na'aseh Adam ne'emar ba'avurecha, you are just like Adam HaRishon, and at the same time, all these things, you want to see the face of God, look at me. The world, in my merit, how do you reconcile both of these? To understand this, let's understand for a second the Seder HaTfilah. We know that there are what we call Neshamot De'atzilut. The Neshama of Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai was the Neshama of Atzilut. There are 4 worlds. We see in the Sidur, you say Korbanot, you come to the world of action. There are Neshamot, souls which come from the world of action. Or in Hebrew, of Akshan, right? Action. Then you have the world of Yetzirah, Olama Yetzirah, the world of formation. That's from Hodu all the way to Barichu. And there are Neshamot, which are a higher level. Neshama of the Rambam, for example, was a Neshama de Bria. The Neshama of the Rambam came from the world of Bria, the next level, which is the level where we say the Shema. Neshama de Atzilut, you have Moshe Rabbeinu, you have the Avot, Abraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov, Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai. Atzilut is the Amidah. What happens at the moment of the Amidah? And what happens before that? Why do we have to mention the Malachim, Michael, Lov Hashem, Gabriel, Fir Hashem, Kulam Nonim Reshut Zelaze, Kulam Kehad Onim Be'ema, that they, in front of the king, they all unite and they say Kadosh. Why do I need to know about angels? And why do I need to know that under these angels, under the Seraphim, you have the Ofanim, which are in the Tza'aka, they have a cry to Hashem, Baruch Kevod Hashem Imekomo. Because when the lower angels hear about the higher angels, they wish they had that connection, they get out of themselves. And that's why it says, it's Shirat Shirat HaMalachim, Kadosh, Kadosh, Kadosh. Why do we need to know this? Who cares? We're talking to Hashem. Because it says in Chassidut, in Kabbalah, that the residue of the Neshamot, of the Malachim, of the angels, from the residue, the Shmarim, the physical body of a Jew was made. So when you see that the Malach is completely surrendered to Hashem, you, that you're just a little piece of poop of the Malach, how much more so? That's why we have a mitzvah, Minui Melech, that the king would surrender to Hashem, the whole nation would see this, they would have a level of bitul. Said, what happens at the moment of the Amida? Admor HaZaken says in Shir HaShirim, on the Pasuk, it says the Gemara, Masechet Brachot, page 13. Hat oznecha lema sh'ata motze mipicha. Put your ear and listen to what's coming out of your mouth. That's what it says. What do we say before the Amidah? Adonai, fatai tiftach ufi yagiti ilatech. God, open my mouth so I can say your praise. But how do we translate ufi yagiti ilatecha? I should say my praise to you. But that's not the real translation. That's the lower level of translation. Rabbi Hanina ben Dosa said, how do I know if my tefillah is accepted before Hashem? Im shgura befi mekubal, ve'im lav meturaf. If it's flowing in my mouth, I know it's accepted. If it's not, it's not accepted. What does it mean? It means that you are so much one with Hashem at the moment of the tefillat ha'amida, it's your praise going through my mouth, and I'm listening to what's coming out of my mouth that you, Hashem, are saying. I'm in Atzilut, Olama Atzilut. At the level of the Amidah, you're so much one with Hashem. It's just like in Limud HaTorah, Ta'an Leshonim Ratecha Keoneh Ahar HaKoreh. You are saying the words, and that's why it says, "V'chol makom asher askir et shemi, avo elecha uberavticha." Wherever, it doesn't say wherever my name is mentioned, I will bless you. No, wherever God says, I will mention my name. When you have a limud Torah where you're one with Hashem, where Hashem is speaking, mitoch grono shel Moshe Rabbeinu. Oh, when Hashem is saying the praise in the Amidah, at that moment, you're at the level of Atzilut. And that is the level of a Merkava, a chariot for Hashem. The horse has a will. The driver has a will. The chariot doesn't have a will. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai could say everything because he's the level of Atzilut. When he speaks, what comes out of his mouth is not his words. When he says Torah in Ematov Umanaim and it starts raining outside, it shouldn't rain tonight, we have a party. Then at that moment, it's Hashem speaking. And therefore, we understand, even the Rebbe, the Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai of our generation,
One day, this is between us, huh?
One day in the middle of the Rebbe, which sings, he sings a nigun, Sam Alecha now, Avshi, Kam Alecha, I'm thirsty for you, Hashem. My flesh is consumed for you. Ken Bakodesh Chaziticha, even in the holiness, when I'm close to you, Lirot Uschach Vodecha, I want to see your strength, and I want to see your glory. One day, the Rebbe was so much into the Nigun, the Rebbe sang it like this. Shamata pam? Ken bakodesh chaziticha lirot uzi uchvodi. That's man p'de adon, da p'de rashbi. You come to a level of connection where it's not you anymore. You have nothing to do with anything. Rak ani ve'at boracha yodim et kochacha. The level of atzilut that I'm completely surrendering, Hashem speaks through me, I have nothing to do with anything. Ana simana ve'alma. You go to Orlando, you see a big sign saying, Orlando this way, 26 miles. You see Rabbi Shimon, what do you see? A sign saying, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. That's it. Techuto yagen aleinu shenizkeh. Legal enai v'abita niflaot mitoratecha hu shebi'emoto bizochet hu. The revealing of the Torah. And there's another pasuk. Yagilu ha'atzamot ha'yeveshot, the bones should be revived, and there should be a way of me'ron, should be a way of happiness and joyfulness in a revealed way with Moshiach Tzidkenu, Amen.